Well, hi, everybody. My name is Daniel Gicklhorn. I'm a product director in the global networking team here in Azure. And in this session today, I'm going to take you backstage with Azure Front Door and show you how we use the set of global vantage points that Front Door is deployed at on Microsoft's global network to self-heal and to optimize a set of user experiences for services that are using the Front Door platform. I'm going to get started by setting some context about Front Door in general before I take you behind the scenes, just so that you understand a little bit more about the service. So to get started, Front Door is a versatile service that helps improve the security, reliability, and performance of an application. It is deployed across our global backbone to about 180 edge locations around the world. And it's placed strategically about 30 milliseconds away from end users to best optimize the user performance, connecting through from end users and user devices out on the internet through the edge of our network and down into Azure where your applications are running. Front Door plays a really key role in cloud architectures by serving a perimeter security role to control access to an application and protect against constant and, you know, sort of known threats. It serves as a global load balancer that can help you bake reliability into your application and fail over in case you have some sort of regional failure. And it provides content and application acceleration to improve the performance of either content you're delivering to websites or any kind of applications that are HTTP based that you're running on Azure. Front Door is not a new service. We've been developing it for the last 8 years, and now about 80% of Microsoft SaaS services that you're probably also using today run on Front Door behind the scenes. And it's a platform that we're developing very quickly, and we're expanding to new locations around the world. We've recently deployed quite a bit in Africa, including in Morocco, and we're deploying about one new edge site per week on average to expand this global footprint to even more locations. Front Door works by having a set of global vantage points, meaning deployed in metros close to end users, and it's connected to our global data centers via Microsoft controlled fiber. This gives us a reliable path between our edge and, you know, local metros where, you know, devices sit and our data centers. And Front Door really serves as the bridge at those sites between end user devices and the application sitting on Azure. Front Door uses Anycast technology to drag traffic into the closest edge site, meaning it localizes it to the closest location. And then it can see the full path end to end from that edge site down to the data center. So when it serves as a global load balancer, it can make decisions about what's the best, both reliability and performance-wise, location or backend for it to route traffic to. So it can determine if there's some sort of application failure all the way through the infrastructure from the edge down to the application. If it does detect an issue, it can start to route traffic around those issues, and it can help an application auto heal. So if you have multiple regions, if you're deployed in multiple regions, then it can help you fail over across those very quickly. The way it does this, it uses HTTP instead of DNS. So effectively it is able to make decisions much quicker. DNS has this challenge where due to the fact that it relies on wait times or TTLs to fail over, it can often take a long time to actually fail over across different backends. In particular, this is worst with enterprise and mobile networks. And one showing on screen is an example of this, where it took about an hour to fail over 95% of the users for this application after an incident. And that means a lot in terms of the user experience that customers get when delivering their application and how a service behaves performantly and reliably during outages or during failovers. It does this because, as I said, it's an HTTP service, and it doesn't change the client IP when it fails over. It instead just makes a routing decision to move traffic across backends. And this can really help building individual applications. Behind that is a complex global system that Front Door sits upon. And what I talked about so far is really the reliability that can help at the app level. Going behind the scenes, a part that's not seen as well is how Front Door really heals end-to-end, which includes the portion of Front Door's application that controls and manages the connectivity between end-user devices out on the internet and Front Door itself. And these are things that are generally outside the Microsoft network and more difficult to control. It starts with, as I mentioned, Anycast that helps us auto-heal connectivity coming into Azure and make sure that we can route around connectivity issues that happen out on the internet quickly when possible. But it has another trick up its sleeve where it is able to actually see this path between end-user devices and Azure itself. And it's able to act to mitigate even partial failures or gray failures across that path. So I'm going to get a little bit deeper into that. So the system we use for this is called Map of the Internet. It's deployed, in fact, in many Microsoft products that you may be using today, Office, Windows, others. It is a service that collects information about network telemetry and monitors global internet performance and user experience when it comes to the internet or network connectivity across hundreds of millions of devices in real time. It's connected to our global WAN, and in the case of degradation, it is able to make decisions based on what expected client performance should be. It can disambiguate between wired and wireless connections and networks. It can determine whether an issue is sustained or transient, and it can make decisions to fail traffic over across different paths if it has them available. So it takes this data. What you're seeing on the screen is, in fact, a map of one day. Every green dot is a sample data point that we plotted, but one day of users sending information into this system, and it's you know, done in a privacy-centric way and very carefully, but you know, provides us a really clear view of how do we deliver the most reliable and performant services on the internet, and how do we take applications that are running on Front Door and make them more performant and reliable. So this data comes in, it's turned into a set of signals, and we group all of these users by their geographic location and the infrastructure that they use to connect to Microsoft, either the networks, ISPs, and things out on the internet. That data then goes through a set of machine learning algorithms that process the data and decide if there's an alternative path available, can we take it? Based on that, our network makes automated routing decisions to move traffic around degradation when it can. And that provides a level of auto-healing for us so that in the case of these sorts of issues, we can effectively route around even partial failures out on the internet, which happen incredibly frequently, in addition to large-scale internet outages, which happen at quite frequently as well when you start to operate with services that look at, you know, every geography across the globe. So that's the map of the internet. It's something we've been developing alongside Front Door for a while, and it's something that if you're using the Front Door platform, you don't necessarily get to see up front because it's doing it behind the scenes to make your application experience better. What I'm going to talk about next is how do you use a similar service or part of the map of the internet service for your own applications to make decisions, leveraging the technology that we've built here just with your own data. So let's pretend to start that you're operating a service that has users in many geographies in a given region. You have users that are distributed across a wide area, some on desktop devices, some on mobile devices, and you're trying to understand the difference between those users. So let's pretend you get an email from your leadership that says, hey, I want to understand the difference in performance when I make some sort of network decision or something that will change the performance of web requests going to one endpoint or another. Say you're deciding on using new security services or you're trying to make a decision going from on-prem to cloud, what are the changes in performance? Internet Analyzer is a service that we've provided. You can access it through the Azure Marketplace. And effectively, all you have to do to use it is sign up, It'll give you a link that you embed in your web experience. It is limited to web experiences today. But once you've done that, you deploy a small image to the two different web endpoints or experiences that you have. And that way we can basically pull that image as a test object. And effectively, the Internet Analyzer service moves that, with views of your web page, distributes that JavaScript to your end users, and then runs a series of tests validating the performance between various different endpoints. That then gives us information to share with you, and we move it into a central location where you can then consume it yourself. What you get is a set of scorecards that help you make decisions, both in terms of monitoring behavior over time, as well as information about the differences between, effectively A/B endpoints in your test. This is something that we use internally to make decisions and part of the map of the internet service itself as we start to look at changes in the network. But it's something that we've exposed to you because we know that, reliability, performance, platform management is really key. And it's something that you don't have to look at just at a global scope, but you can actually drill down and access it at a regional scope as well, or be able to split it by country. So that's a quick look into the Azure Front Door service and map of the internet and how it helps behind the scenes to improve the reliability of services that are using our cloud products like Front Door. And thank you for your time. There's a few links on the screen right now that'll help you get more information, and thanks for taking the time with me.
Hey, Daniel, this stuff is super interesting. We have a bunch of questions in chat. I'm wondering if you could stick around so we could ask you for like a good, 5 minutes, maybe even more, if you're up for it.
Absolutely.
Okay, so the first question I have to admit I want to ask, based on the things that have been submitted to us, is somebody asked, and I'm curious about this too, when you say that Azure Front Door helps us route around outages, like what kind of outages are we talking about? What do we actually handle?
Yeah, that's a great question, David. So there have been many different types of infrastructure outages that Map of the Internet has helped us route around in the past. Everything from fibers being dragged off the seafloor to the Super Bowl or large-scale sporting events that congest the internet and cause internet service providers to show degradation, to Microsoft itself having regional issues and things like that that allow us to detect those and make decisions quickly to mitigate.
Okay, cool. Well, so there's a follow-up kind of product-y question that I want to ask. Somebody is asking, thank you very much for your question, Rixar. Is Azure Front Door like other CDNs? Can it be used like other CDNs, like some of our competitors, like Akamai and other people like that who do CDN stuff?
Yeah, no, also great question. Yeah, so Front Door is itself a CDN. It's something that we grew out of Microsoft's enterprise roots. And so it is something that from a, sort of CDN competency perspective is a place where we started. It is a general purpose platform. You can use it like other CDNs, but it's something that we continue to develop on, really focused on cloud first scenarios and cloud native access, agility, and management that will, something that we will build on over the next few years as well.
Cool, okay. And to go a little slightly more technical, someone is asking, Deshaun was asking, where do we find latency benchmarks for Front Door if they want to do that? I wonder if this has to do with the internet and internet analyzer stuff that you were talking about as well.
Yeah, so that's something that we do have coming soon. There are a couple sources out there that have done latency benchmarks independently. We're currently working with a couple of different providers as our new version of the products, Front Door Standard and Premium, come out early next year to provide more standardized public latency benchmarking.
Cool. And by the way, those little bling noises you hear, because I get them too, are people asking questions. So we're going to do our best to get as many of the questions as we can during this time before we have to move over to our next session. So let's do some more questions. Here's a really fun one from Andre. What kind of clients are sending the telemetry for Map of the Internet? Like, where are we getting that data from?
Yeah, also a great question. So there are a combination of different basically rich and thin client experiences. It's deployed in Windows, builds that are more recent. It's deployed in Office, but also in a collection of web experiences. And so the diversity of different types of clients that we have sending us information, again, in a very privacy-centric way, gives us the ability to see, you know, very basic web experience telemetry all the way up through, you know, what you'd be experiencing connecting through, say, an Outlook or a desktop-based application in Office.
And I know that I'm kind of excited the fact that we can take like all that data and with, you know, Internet Analyzer and with just the routing functionality, use it for good. You know, like it's really cool to, it's cool to collect data, but it's even cooler to actually use it for like people's best purposes. Okay, so more questions are coming in, but we're gonna have to wrap very soon. I guess the next question that I see here, and then maybe we'll wrap and we'll start moving towards the next session, is one around expansion. You had said something about the fact that we're expanding the network, you know, the points of presence. Can you say a little bit more about that? I didn't remember the exact stat you gave.
Yeah, so right now we're expanding at about one new site per week. Sometimes those are in existing metros for reliability. Sometimes they're in new metros. We've gone to a lot of new geographies in the last 18 months. We continue to expand. Part of the benefit of the map of the internet service gives us visibility into where we should expand to improve user experience. And so it is a place we're making lots of investments. If you saw the map that I shared on the second slide, there are a lot of places in the globe that still don't have little white dots. And as we expand to meet more users where they are, we will continue to move both our CDN, our front door locations, as well as our global network into lots of new metros over time.
Awesome. Well, we got a bunch more questions. They're in the chat. If you have a moment, Daniel, would really appreciate it if you would drop in the chat an answer. I know you've been on camera, so it's kind of hard to do both at the same time. Thank you so much for this behind the scenes at this sort of stuff. So with that, I think we can say thank you very much for reliability. And now we get to move on to another pillar of the well-architected framework.